हेलो गाइस, यू आर वाचिंग वॉइस टेक इंजीनियरिंग यूट्यूब चैनल बाय मोहम्मद अब्दुल महबूब एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू द प्रोजेक्ट डेवलपमेंट ऑफ सरफेसेस ऑफ दिस प्रॉब्लम. सो हाउ टू ड्रॉ दिस प्रॉब्लम आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू इन डिटेल. सो प्लीज गाइस वॉच माय वीडियोस टिल द एंड एंड इफ यू लाइक दिस प्रॉब्लम प्लीज शेयर लाइक एंड सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल एंड ऑल्सो प्रेस माय यूट्यूब चैनल बेल आइकॉन टू गेट यू द मोर नोटिफिकेशंस ऑफ अदर वीडियोस एंड प्लीज आफ्टर वॉचिंग माय वीडियोस ऑल्सो प्रैक्टिस बाय योरसेल्फ. Then only you come to understand. I will starting my problem now. A hexagonal pyramid of base edge 30 mm and axis height 65 mm rest with its base on HP such that the two parallel base edges of the pyramid are perpendicular to VP. Draw the development of the pyramid. So we have to develop the hexagonal pyramid. So how is the hexagonal pyramid? We are having a hexagon six sides, and this is the pyramid like this. Okay, and this is the hexagonal pyramid. First, we have to draw the orthographic view. Orthographic view means front view and top view. As given in the question, how to draw this? First, we have to draw that. So, hexagonal pyramid. First, you have to draw a XY line like this, and vertical plane VP, horizontal plane downwards HP. So, to draw the hexagon, first you have to draw a hexagon by the circle method. I am drawing a hexagon. So, hexagon side. Hexagon pyramid of base edge is how much? 30 mm. So we have to adjust on divider 30 mm. Okay, and we have to draw by circle. I am drawing a hexagon. I draw a circle. It should be somewhat light. According to the pencil, you can draw. And with this center point, perpendicular to this point, you have to take a point on that circle like this. Okay, then after with the same dimension you have drawn the circle, with the same dimension on this point you have to take the arcs on the circles one by one like this. And after taking the arcs, just join these arcs by the lines like this. Your hexagon will be created. Okay, then after you have to rub this hexagon only. Sorry, we have only circle, so we don't need circle. Sorry, I am rubbing by circle method. I have drawn hexagon. What arcs you have drawn, you can rub it. Okay, then after creating hexagon, you have to label these points, center point as O, O1, and hexagon pyramid. If pyramid is there, you have to do labeling, a single labeling A, B, C, D, E, F. If prism is there, you have to do double labeling. So labeling also done. Then after, from the each point, you have to take the projection line till XY line like this, from A and F over, so from B, O and E over, then C and D is also over. So this after. Doing projection line, you have to dark this line, base of the pyramid. Then after, you have to draw the pyramid here. So how to draw this means only you need the axis height. In the question, axis height is given 65 mm. So you have to draw an axis line of 65 mm. From here, 65 mm you have to take. Okay, I am taking the 65 mm distance. Now to draw this axis line, if it is an axis line or a doing a dark line. So by the procedure, you have to see this hexagon from the downwards. Means before this origin, your B edge is visible. Okay, so if B is visible before O, means you have to do it dark. Otherwise, you have to draw axis line. Okay, then after draw this line edges by joining these two lines ends like this, your pyramid will be created. Okay, now you have to do the labeling here. So you have to see this hexagon from the downwards for each labeling. First, if you see downwards, A is visible, so you have to write it as A dash. B is also visible from downwards, B dash. C is also visible, C dash. B is not visible from downwards. It is somewhat dark side. So for the invisibility point, you have to write it in bracket as D dash. And E is also not visible from downwards. So in bracket. F is also not visible. It is also in bracket. Remaining O dash you have to write. And this O1, you have to do it as O1 dash here. Then after, you have to show the dimension by taking the perpendicular extension line with the axis, then dimensioning line, arrow marks, and its axis is 65 mm. And side of the hexagon is, by taking extension line, you have to show the side also, dimensioning line, arrow marks, and it is 30 mm. And this is the orthographic view. Okay, in this question, the important point is that before creating the development of this pyramid, because in the question, the development of the pyramid is said, before constructing this development of pyramid, first we have to see there, right? In the question, he is saying that such that the two parallel base edges of the pyramid, means this base edges of the pyramid, but two parallel edges, means these parallel edges where you are having parallel edges, it should be perpendicular to the pyramid. Base edges of the pyramid are perpendicular to VP, means it should be perpendicular. So when after drawing this, these two parallel base edges of the pyramid is not getting perpendicular, so we have to remove the true length. So how to remove this true length? We have to take a line from this O point like this, then on the divider keep on O, on this C, then take an arc till that line you have created like this. Then after, with that point, you have to take the x1 till the x1 line, straight line, vertical line. Then after, with this end, with this O1 dash, you have to join it. And that this distance of the pyramid is the true length. With this true length only, we have to construct the development of the surface of the pyramid. So we have to measure the distance of this true length and taking somewhere a point, anywhere. So on that point, we have to take an arc like this. Okay, and this point will be the O1 dash. Okay, hexagon is having six sides, so we have to take the side of the hexagon as how much we are having, 30 mm. So first you draw a line from here like this. Okay, from here you have to draw 30-30 distance arcs. How many? Six triangles you should have of this pyramid, because hexagon is having six sides. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, then after, join this line with this O1 dash, with that arcs. Okay, now your pyramid is having also a side, so you have to create the sides also by this one like this. And here labeling will be A, B, C, D, E, F, then one more A. Also you have to show the side of this pane. According to this line, extension line should be perpendicular, and dimensioning line, and this dimensioning line is 30 mm. Okay, and this is the development of the pyramid. Hexagonal pyramid. And I hope this is the complete solution of this problem. Hope guys, if you like my videos, please share, like and subscribe my channel, and also press my YouTube channel bell icon to get you the more notifications of other videos. And after watching my videos, please also practice by yourself, then only you will come to understand how to draw this problem. Thank you.